Good morning. I've been up since 3 something. Took a train to Aschaffenburg. Now I'm in Aschaffenburg. This is what that looks like. It's a train station. And then meeting Jens in the next train, which will take us 4 hours into that place south, Austria, where Andy will pick us up, hopefully, at the train station, and off we go.
Hello, I made it on the train that's going to now last for 4 hours, but I have company. There's Jens, and this is Germany.
Andy has picked us up at the train station. Then we had unhealthy food. Then we are here. I'm good at vlogs.
Is this you vlogging?
This me vlogging. I don't know what people want to see. I don't have a guitar in my hand. I have no idea why they're watching this.
You can tell them where we are. You can tell them where we're going.
We are here. We're going
there.
There. Why are you laughing, Andy?
Yes, Henning. And Henning's people. Hello. I'm impressed with your vlogging skills. I'm impressed with how real you make it and how natural. It's like almost being in the car with you.
I don't know. What do you people want to know? We're in Austria. We're driving. Jens is in the back somewhere there. There's PJD guitars in the trunk. We had McDonald's and a coffee. I pooped. Took a poop. Andy peed. I have a picture. I might throw that in here. Yeah. And then the next scene will be us further towards Venice. I don't know why you watch vlogs.
Well, generally speaking, vlogs are a little bit more fast-paced than this, with cutting and editing.
I don't edit.
And you go, whoosh, whoosh, and you, whoosh, and then, you know, you do that sort of thing.
I don't do that sort of thing.
Yeah, but people are going to expect it now, which is why they're going to stay for it, and then you're not going to give it to them.
You're not going to edit. No, there's no editing. There's, here's what we did. 30 minutes of it.
Well, we've got another 2 hours, 43 minutes to go, so you could just make them watch 2 hours and 43 minutes worth.
Of what?
Of this.
We are now going into Italy. And apparently this is what I'm supposed to film.
Right, there's lorries who are not allowed into Italy yet.
So we filled out a huge form that took an hour to fill out.
Yes.
To not show it to anyone.
Yes. And also you should be pointing the camera that way, because that's Italy. And they know what we look like.
That's Italy. We have arrived in Padua, which is where the trade show is, and this is our lobby. Andy right now is freaking out because he bought the exact same camera copycatter that I have, and he can't log in.
I've logged in. Look, there's my password.
He can't set it up because he's trying to copycat me with a little camera, and he doesn't know what he's doing. And I'm enjoying this very much. I'm gonna go and eat somewhere in a Ristorante. That's French for Hungarian. Bye-bye. So Andy just turned off his camera, and if this is a continuation of his shot...
It's not even red yet.
But on another channel.
Where are we going?
Where are we going? This is not correct.
dogfight. Italian dogfight. Does this mean the people watching my channel are now watching the people watching your channel?
I'm very confused about what's going on. This apparently is the biggest piazza in the universe.
Well, when I'm walking across, yeah.
I don't know. Doesn't seem that big to me.
What constitutes a piazza, is my question.
It's when there's cheese on it. And, and tomato sauce. What else is a piazza?
I don't know. What's a piazza with you?
Pineapple?
It's a pickup for acoustic guitars, isn't it?
Oh! Nice. I want to borrow a guitar and an amplifier, and when England win the football on Sunday. If they win, which they will, then I will play God Save the Queen on a stage in front of a load of Italian people. Yeah.
While Andy is talking about fuzzes, yes. I will be showing the people the drive into Venice.
Okay, then you pointed the camera the correct way, because Venice is over there. So.
I didn't say I'm showing them Venice. I'm showing them the drive into
the
Venice.
Drive. Okay, well, if you're going to go,
and
to
this
Venice,
is the drive.
This is the drive. This
if you're going to Venice
stuff,
and you're sitting in our
you
car, that is what it's going to look like.
What
yeah.
You're gonna be at
yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
We think we're funny. So there's the Venice parking garage. Andy, can you say that again?
Yeah, Venice is a little island, I don't know if you know.
You didn't know?
I did know, yeah. I knew this. There was no question that I didn't know that Venice was an island.
So how old were you when you learned that Venice is an island?
40 in about a month.
So roughly now?
Yeah, about 2 seconds ago before this video started. It makes a lot of sense, because I always wondered, like, when the sea level rises, why does Venice, you know, get flooded? But now I know, because it's an island. As Jens said, you know, how big is Venice, basically? 500 meters? Okay, so Venice is only 1 kilometer, no, 1, 2, 3, 4. Venice is 5 kilometers-ish, if my scale is correct, from the long bit to the other long bit, which would make that about 2.5.
Okay, I'm going to give you a little bit of history. This bridge was built fairly recently, and they couldn't use it for the most part because in the winter, these glass bits were so slippery that people literally, like, slid down the whole bridge. I've seen videos of them, and people go like, boop, 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 and end up at the bottom. That is a true story, you can look it up. They had to redo these glass things and make them less slippery.
I didn't know you did such a good Dr. Slipknot. Oh my goodness, there's a Venetian canal.
How much is it to rent one of those body boats? This is neat. There's a park, Parking Mac Park Face. There's a barge, Venetian barge. So Michiel just pointed out that this is the exact spot where in Indiana Jones and the Holy Temple of Grail, Indy gave a rose to the Nazi Elsa. And it is. It is literally that spot. There's the door that we can see in the scene. And there's the dome in the background. And this is where they land, actually in one of those bays. I mean, it's kind of sad to reduce Venice to, you know, an Indiana Jones movie, but that's what we do because we are not cultured. We're not in the club. We're not in the culture club.
Why not?
Because we're reducing Venice to Indiana Jones instead of all the culture around us.
That's pop culture.
Well, I'm saying we're not in the culture club.
Come on.
I'm here for the food, coffee.
And if we had like a candle, yes, it would be culture candela.
Children to feed, and you're messing around as if it's like some kind of joke.
This is my job. I have dogs to feed, and you're messing around like this is some kind of joke.
It's almost as if you don't respect me.
It's almost as if you copied my camera.
Someone's definitely blowing their horn again.
Yes.
Which is the main soundtrack to Italy and Venice.
I was distracted.
Very distracting you.
Wearing a mask, which is kind of weird. I wonder if the mask sales have gone down since people started wearing masks. Because, can you wear a mask? I don't know. But look at the masks. They're pretty ridiculous. Redonkulous, even.
If we were sensible, we'd be using mode to be real and making money.
Batman. I'm Batman.
And I really should buy the unicorn.
This is where Christopher Walken first discovered Italy and Venice. And it's actually where the phrase from Taxi Driver comes from. So, hey, I'm walking here. Comes from when he first discovered all the water. Luckily, they built this city right next to where the water is.
Which, they built this city.
Yeah, on rock and stilts. Not a lot of people are aware that underneath this is another city. This is the sanitation system here in Venice. They turned into a shop and attraction. It's quite remarkable what people will pay for.
You made something beautiful, very disgusting, Andy.
Well, that's usually your job.
Andy, where are we?
We're in Markusplatz.
What was about your balls?
My bald head is really sweaty underneath this wig.
I heard something about your balls, though.
Yeah, they were stuck to my leg.
Okay, but now where are we?
Venice.
Jens?
I can confirm. It is. People tell me it is. They have a lot of coffee around and people and...
Yeah, but where are we specific?
He said it.
You need to pay attention.
Where Marcus Platz, Marcus something, Placide, Marco di Forilio, di Le Cancello, della Papalilu.
Can you please give these people some real information? Marcus Aurelio from Gladiator.
Ah.
Once came here and did this, all the grain in the field.
And the grain was here?
Yeah, it's here.
That was the field from Gladiator.
This is where they filmed it. As you know, Venice has been featured in many movies, such as Spider-Man, Far From Home.
Yes.
Indiana Jones and the Falafel King.
Also others that Michelle knows and we don't.
Yeah. And behind us is the latest, well, I'd say latest, but one of the most recent Starbucks.
This is Disney that built that only 3 years ago.
Thank you.
So we've just arrived at the guitar show in Padua, Italy. I mean, we've been in Padua, but we've just arrived at the show. And here we are looking for food.
Cat.
Can we eat that cat?
No.
Okay.
You're not Alf.
I'm
trying to do something here. Guitar Show Italy, first day done. And
whoa. I'm just gonna get back in the saddle.
Okay, now the joke is done. Can I now narrate?
Sure, go for it.
Guitar Show Italy, the first day is done. The bros are on their way to the food. I don't know. And how do you do cool videos, Andy? Can you teach me?
Yeah, you gotta go like that.
Oh, that's a stupid idea. So we're trying to find food. We are very, very tired. It was a long day. Show was a bit smaller than expected, but cool people. We found some very interesting guitars. Of course, they will be in very interesting videos, not in the vlog, because we want you to watch the videos. Anything you want to add?
No, not me. Andy, you?
No thanks. Oh, go on then. I played a great fuzz pedal today.
No such thing.
I lied. Played three.
Lee Henning is also vlogging this, so we just had. Thank you. We just had mozzarella sticks, which I'm sure is what you needed to know. And Henning's about to knock over a bottle of limonada.
This bottle.
Overall, today was a huge success. Played some gorgeous guitars, some great amps, one amp that wasn't even for sale, and some good pedals. Generally speaking, today was wonderful. I'm going to give it a solid 7 out of 9.
I'm going to give it 8.37 out of Krumpach.
He's getting it, he's learning. I've been teaching him all weekend and his camera work is fantastic. His use of shots, lights and angles are certainly improving.
Oh my God, is it color bright? That's a good guitar. Hello, we are here, the three musketeers. Well, two musketeers and a baby in a mustache.
A mustache, too.
Why is he doesn't look like a baby in a mustache?
Only in that photo.
Ah, in that photo. Now I get it. We're walking towards the football.
The middle of the road.
Yeah, but something about football. I'm wearing an Italian flag shirt. At least that's what I think the Italian flag is. I don't know what the flag looks like.
Who's playing?
Germany and India.
Italy and England.
Close enough.
As an Englishman, being in Italy on this day could... It feels like the like a very exciting move.
Could be a deadly move.
This may be the last video footage you ever see of me. Thanks for watching and keep my channel going even when I'm not there. Just keep subbing, you know, with all the...
What are they going to watch if there's no new content?
Just watch all the old stuff and just think, he was too young. He was too young and too pretty. But also, I hope that the English fans are respectful because they've been awful during the national anthems of the other countries. Have you seen this?
Nope.
They've been...
Have you seen this?
They've been booing the national anthem of the other countries.
Oh, that is freaking wrong. I'm not a patriot in any way, but let people listen to that.
It was
anthem.
Fine when they did it to Germany, but everybody else... No, there was some misbehavior on behalf of the English fans, and that's not nice.
Andy, what?
And then there's cameras, of course.
We're trying to watch the football. Instead, we walked up there, up that long place, which takes us way over there by the train station. And now, we're walking in a car park that has fences all around it.
People mover, and moving people. Fence gap. Andy, what just happened?
England just scored and I'm in Italy. And there's only like, what, 2 or 3 minutes passed?
The game is now what apparently I have learned is called overtime, which is where the time never ends and there's an abundance of it after the actual game, trying to figure out who wins that game. This time that's over is over now, and now apparently, I don't know, some special rule, something about kicking each other, I don't know. Let's ask Andy what he thinks about the current situation of this ping pong game.
You just score a goal. I mean, I'm not very technical when it comes to teams and football and sports, but I believe that if England were to score a goal and Italy were to not score a goal, I think that would be a good thing right now. I'm clenching my hands together. I don't know that I'm doing that. What do you want? I don't even like your song. I'm about to rip this table in half. What? What do you want? I told you once. No! The pressure is like not having a new fuzz pedal every day. It's like watching one of your videos, Henning, and having to actually get some information from it. It's terrible. Like, when's it going to happen? Is it going to be ever over? Am I going to get beaten up at the end of it?
What does that mean? Have they won?
Well, what happened is that Italy scored... Come back and say that! That's just scared me. Yeah, so Italy scored more penalties, and that's a mistake on England's part.
I don't really know what's going on. I just want to go bed.
Yeah, I want to go bed.
Okay.
Now, but I just want to say, penalties is no way to decide anything.
And well, tell the people what we thought should happen.
Hang on a minute. Hi, Yunia.
So, I told you.
What'd you tell me?
That we will win.
Yeah, but you didn't tell me that your captain is going to try and kill all the English people and not get a red card.
I didn't see the match.
Sorry, Andy.
A little part of me is just glad it's over. And I mean that in a good way, because now I can actually go to bed after a long day of work. I'm upset, but more on the case of that they did work really, really hard. And it's always a good idea that to work hard and gain something. But, you know, with football, there can only be one winner. And sadly, that wasn't us today. How was that?
I mean, they'll just do it next time, right?
Yeah, just do it next time. Just sort of regroup, change the strategy, kick the ball a bit better. And next time, put it in the net.
And that's it from Sports Center Italy. I was your host, Henning, and this was your host, Andy. And bedtime. So everyone's honking their hornsies and stuff, and people
are going in the opposite direction.
People are happy. Andy, how do you feel about the complete and utter defeat of your countrymen? Rightfully so, without any fault of the referee at all about Mr. Shirtbully Man.
Well, I feel that I let the country down. I take full responsibility.
You didn't hit the table hard enough.
I didn't hit the table hard enough. I didn't jump up hard enough and then try and hide it a little bit. You know, I don't make a Let's Watch Henning's Video and Boom channel, do I?
No. I mean, I always say very nice things about your channel, even to your face. No, don't make that channel.
Where I just watch your videos and go all the time.
That would be I would watch that. Yeah. We're on the way back to where we came from. It's the end of the trip.
Bloody isn't. 4 hours left, yeah.
It's 4 hours before the end of the... No. Well, then I have another 5 hours on the train.
True.
It's 9 hours before the end of the trip. But it's the last leg of the trip.
The last leg of the trip, correct.
Why do they say leg? Because we're in Italy. Jens has double coffee, triple coffee. He buys a cappuccino and puts a double espresso in the cappuccino.
I mean, it takes a lot of energy to sit here, right?
We are in the hilly part of Italy, called Hiddily, and it...
That was all right.
I landed one. And it is 4 days and I made it funny.
Have you ever wondered what an Italian tunnel looks like? You're about to find out.
That sounded kind of dirty. Italian tunnel. So.
Allora.
We're heading home. And then there's lots of editing. Met some very nice people. Most of them Italian. And then there was also us, not Italian. I think my vlogging skills have gone way up. Andy taught me so much about you have to turn the camera on, point it at the things you want to film, and also talk about things. Don't just point.
Don't forget about the swipey swipey transitions.
Do we need swipey swipey transitions?
No, really.
I have postcard animation. Should I use them?
No.
No?
Yes.
Yes?
I don't know.
If I do, next thing is gonna be Andy's gonna go to my secret hidey place where I buy my plugins and then buys it and then uses it too and says he used it first. Cause that's how he rolls. That's what he does.
Well, I never claimed I used the comic stuff first, I just used it. I don't watch your videos, I don't know what you use.
Oh, you do? You do know what I use. Oh, you do.
I watch this one.
And then he tells me how horrible my vlogging is, and he'd be right. So, thank you for sticking with us through thick and thin. It was fun. It was fun delivering this amazing content to you. All this mediocre content, but it is content and you see some cool stuff. We met some nice people. It was a good trip, and the trip is only possible because of you. When I looked in the hotel room at my laptop and the footage that we did in Venice,
I see Jens strolling down a little alley, and then all of a sudden, you know, Chipman comes in and is there too. I realized how lucky I am to have met these guys because of the channel. The channel only exists because of you viewers. And, you know, Jens is a friend, and he invited us to the trip and said, hey, come with us, come with me, I don't want to go alone. And all these people I only know because of the channel, and the channel only exists because of the viewers, and the viewers is you. So thank you for making this trip possible. It's pretty amazing.
Are you doing that thing that I do when I get, like, emotional to try and draw people in and fake my way through it so people actually think I have a heart and I care about stuff?
No, I actually am emotional about that. Shut up. I know,
I was just using comedy to...
Yeah, I know.
Comedy to deflect the fact that I was a little bit touched then.
I actually... you were a lot touched last night.
Right, we're about to go through one of those... Hang on. We're going to go through one of those... sorry to spoil your moment, but one of those things where I got to give money and you need to give me that ticket that I've been through at the window.
Ticket! And thank you, Andy, for driving us, by the way.
You're welcome.
Is there a driving charge?
Yes.
Oh.
20% of you guys have to leave Henning and come over to my channel. You figure out the math.
You know they can subscribe to both channels, right?
Nah, not worth it. People have got time. That's it. There's only so much time in this world.
Thank you.
Here we go.